All right, guys, it's week three, and let's put that armature together that we didn't put together last week.
Okay, so this here is a tie down, so it's basically like a wing nut, and then like another nut that turns up and down on this side. And I got a little base. I usually make a little base so that when I'm building the puppet, you know, I got something for it to stand on. I got some holes here. I usually drill three sixteenths. Is that what they are? Yeah, 3/16 holes. And then what basically happens is this goes through the bottom of this thing. And then it comes out the hole, like right there. Let me show you on the bottom. This one's soldered on so it doesn't turn. And then when you turn that one, it tightens the foot down. That goes into the tie down on the foot, like right there, and I got it right there. I do double tie downs on the feet as like an insurance policy. For one thing, it's nice because then you can have them stand on one toe. But the other thing is, and this did actually happen on my last movie, if you strip out one of these, you still got one to help you finish up the shot. Okay, so I tied it down. So here's the ankles, they go on right there. And I also try to keep the bolts going to the outside. So that say like something untightens, gets loose, needs to get fixed, and this guy's like a fully dressed puppet, I can come in and know where the Allen wrench fits. I can just go straight to that bolt. See this joint, let me show you guys this, is actually one that I made. And these are the ones I just made on that last video. So this is the store-bought plates. And everybody's asking me where I get these plates. So this is actually them. I'm going to show you guys. And these guys are great. I buy the threaded balls there. They have threaded rod. I don't know if they've got complete armatures that you can just flat out buy. But you can buy it. Almost everything you need for an armature. Actually, here's some of their bags of stuff. So like there's the plates I've been buying, which is just awesome, you know. And everything fits like the way it should fit. I'll throw that up one more time just so you guys can see. And it's actually, you know, pretty decently priced. And you know, you don't really need to probably even mess with like single ball joints and things like that. If you just bought all their stuff the way they have it, you bought their screws, you could put together an armature with just their stuff. You wouldn't need a machine like anything, you know. It's just more like me and my, you know, the way I think everything's got to be done is why I've got to mess with everything. But, you know, just like looking at my joints, though, I really feel like there's just not much difference. This is how I did the last puppet, when I did everything out of brass instead of steel. And it worked great. And this one's working good too. So I don't know. Will I keep buying their plates and stuff? I probably will, just because it saves me some time. But, you know, I wanted to point that out because it's not like you can't make this out of a piece of flat bar. It's easy. So here we go with the knees now. They go on there right like that. Now these ones, I was going to show you this too. I bought some... I don't know what these are called, but basically they're like cap screws. These were 5mm, which actually fits pretty well into an 8/32 hole, but it's not the exact same thing. And the thing I don't kind of like about these is they take like this little thin hex nut, and it works fine, but it's easy to strip these out. And so these are the ones I use, and they take this one. And as you can see, it's quite a bit bigger. I think that's one of the things I really realized is, you know, like when I made my last puppets, I made them the size that I thought made sense. And so they were pretty big. They were like, you know, 12, 13 inches. Online, I noticed there's just so many people who were like, oh my God, you know, they're so big. Why do you make them so big? And it kind of gave me like this complex of, you know, like, oh, I need to make these tiny puppets, you know? But, with these characters, I made them significantly smaller than the last puppet I made, but I just realized like it just makes everything harder. That's what I noticed about that. It just really makes everything harder. And I don't think I've really gained anything by making them smaller, you know? Anyway, like with these cap screws, I kind of been going through and just switching these out. So that we got 8/32 going through there. It's actually what size these are threaded, so they hold a little bit better. And then I just don't like, I don't like having something like that in my puppet that can easily be screwed up, and then I have to take stuff apart and like redo stuff, you know. So I'm gonna pop those out and put those in. One thing about these though, and I'm not gonna throw them all away because, you know, they do that nice low profile. So if you really did have like a joint that needed to go into like something really skinny, you know, you could do these bolts. You could do the smallest plates that they sell, which is like these ones. You know, that one's actually got that bolt in there. Then you could get a very, you know, low profile joint. And that's awesome if you need that. Just as long as I'm undoing these, I'll just talk for a second. That's another thing I've noticed, you know, with the armatures is, you know, you buy some stuff and you do it one way, and then, you know, you kind of realize, like, oh, well, this would have worked better that way. This would have worked better that way. So it's almost like every armature you make gets a little bit better. And even on the next one I'll make, there's a couple different things I'm gonna try to do a little bit like differently. So, yeah. So I think there's just no one right way, you know. But there's also like, I think sometimes when you do things wrong, you can still make them work too. That's the other thing I'm realizing. It's like not everything works perfectly the way you think it's gonna. But maybe it still worked and it works well enough to, you know, get by, you know, and that's good too. Here's the torso. This is actually the back, and as you can see, there's like a you know, there's a pipe or a square tube coming out there. There's a square tube coming this way. It's a square tube coming that way. And what that is for is see what I mean? You can put that in there, and then you have a rigging point, so this puppet can be off the ground or just tied down to somewhere. And you know, I got three options. I got like right through the butt and through the sides. And this is important. This is something I did not realize when I did my last animation, is that this, you know, to have a rigging point and also just have your puppets on a rig, it's really hard to make them walk and do all that stuff with the tie downs. And so a rig just makes it all easier because your puppet's stuck there and you can move them. You can make them walk, you know, pretend walk if you're not shooting the feet, things like that. And it just works great. So getting those in your puppets is it's just a massive advantage in my opinion. So anyway, this has got to go to the back. And here's the joint for the hip. I'm going to get it tightened on there. So this is a little after the fact voiceover because I didn't really record this while it was all happening. But I wanted to let you guys know. I wasn't 100% happy with the way the hips worked on the puppet. And I was kind of, they just didn't seem to have like a lot of, like, movement. They had a lot of forward and back movement, but they didn't have kind of like any side movement. And I think it was just because I had such small plates and the smaller balls. So I had the 6mm balls in the hips. And so up to this point, this is the first puppet I've ever made with the 6mm balls in the hips. And I think that just because the plate was so small with the smaller ball, it just was restricting the movement so much that I was like messing around with it and trying to just figure out like why it wasn't moving as much as I thought it should. And it actually broke, the post broke off. And I was like, I got to redesign this real quick. I got to like figure out something else. And so I went ahead and soldered on 8mm balls on the tops of the thighs and then like the bottoms of the hips. And that's what you're seeing me do here. I'm not exactly sure why it broke. You know, I don't know if I had the solder joint. It just wasn't quite what it was supposed to be. Like I said in the past, I'm not like the best at soldering. And I'm like always learning. I'm getting a little bit better at it since I've been doing it so much on these puppets. But I really think that it was just the stress. That joint was so small that like when you would get that side movement on that joint, it was just really stressing where that post was soldered into the actual hips. So at any rate, that's stop motion. You know, you just like always have like all of these hurdles that you got to jump over and fix and all that. But anyway, here I am with the finished balls and putting together the armature, and it's working out well.
Okay, so that's how they came out. I made sure I got a good solder on them this time. I redid the balls on the top of the legs. And so this is how this is going to be.
I can already tell that's better. Okay, so that's definitely a better... Can you believe this dog? Listen to him. Barking at the mail lady out there. But I can already see, like, you see what I mean? I have some movement now suddenly. It's not nearly as tight around there. See, Moon came walking in here just now to tell me, yeah, I chased the mail lady off. Don't worry. Okay, now let's do the shoulders. So this is something else I've debated about, is the design right here on these shoulders. The original puppets I made when I made the Wolf's Heart actually had two joints. So they had like a double ball here and then another double ball joint here. And it brought them out further so they could have kind of like wider shoulders. And then when I actually made the puppets, when I put the foam on, put the costumes on, I realized I thought they were too big. And I ended up taking one of the ball joints out and just doing this design here where it's like you got the torso, double ball joint down to the arm, and it always looks to me like it's too narrow, you know, like when you're in this situation, especially looking at the puppet, it just looks like that, you know, it's too narrow, it's like too tight to the body. But I don't know, I'm gonna trust it for now. I can always come back, this is not a tough joint to make, and make another one and just see if it works out the same way again. But that I am liking a lot. That's working real nice. Let's put the other one on. And the one thing I'm liking a lot better with this one too is the larger cap screws that I put on. I just like being able to get my hex wrench in there and really tighten if I need to. Not have to worry about things maybe getting stripped out. Oh, that works so nice. Look at that. That is perfect. This torso might need a little bit more tension. There we go. That is really working nice.
I think that switching these out and making them the 8mm balls in the hips and then having the torso, that works so much better. And it's honestly making me think about possibly doing shoulders like that too. There's the two puppets together. Two puppets, that's awesome. And this one came out taller. That's how it's supposed to be. This is like the bigger guy. This is the smaller guy. You know, this is kind of sort of like the brains and the muscle kind of deal. Let me go grab my other puppet. Check it out. Yes, man, I can't wait to get going on this. Yep, it's actually happening. Yes. super happy right now, though. So, two puppets, one more to go. Then I guess maybe I'm actually going to start costuming. I'm not sure. I have the other, you know, the other characters, they're not humanoid. So I'm like, oh man, I'm going to have to like design armatures that work differently. I don't know. It's all a lot of work. But I'm trying, like I said, I'm trying to get this all done in a year. So my goal is like around Christmas time. I don't know. I don't know if it'll work, but that's what I'm trying. That's what I'm trying right here. Anyway, that's it. Like, subscribe, all that stuff. See you guys next time.